Friends, welcome back to Wikipedia World. Our last lecture was a loaded lecture on gears and gear system with a lot of theory and a lot of symbols and numerical representations. So today's lecture, we will begin by revisiting those relations. We will collectively see all those relations and we will just refresh our memory to understand them again, and we'll also see a concept or two which are new concepts which I actually missed out. They are mainly some terminologies like gear ratio. What do we understand by a gear ratio? So when I will be teaching those aspects, kindly update your lecture notes from the previous lecture. And once we are done with all this, we will see a numerical on gear system, and using that numerical we will refresh the whole lecture and we'll understand it much more clearer and in a crisp way. So let us jump right into and see some of the relations we discussed in the last lecture. So these are some of the important relations which we discussed in our last lecture. The most important relation which we found was the relation between the number of rotations, the number of teeth, and the radius of the gears for the driving and the driven wheel. We saw that more the radius, more the number of teeth, and less will be the revolution speed. Then we had something which is known as the velocity ratio. This is actually a new term. We have seen what velocity ratio is, but we did not know that that is called as the velocity ratio. So velocity ratio is basically defined as the ratio for the velocity of the driven wheel to the velocity or the rotation speed of the driving wheel. So this velocity ratio basically tells us how much in what ratio has the speed of gear been fastened in the driven gear compared to the driving gear. So that is velocity ratio. This is a new terminology. Kindly update your note. And this is another new terminology, gear ratio. So what is gear ratio? Gear ratio is defined as the ratio of the number of teeth in the driving wheel, or rather driving gear, to the driven gear. So this is for driving and this is driven. Gear ratio is ratio of number of teeth in driving to the number of teeth in driven gear. Gain in torque, we saw in the last lecture I mentioned about this, that it is ratio between number of teeth in the driven to that of driving gear. So gear ratio and gain in torque are reciprocal. And since NB by NA can also be written as RB by RA, gain in torque is also the ratio of the radius of the driven to the radius of the driving gear. Finally, there is something which is called as the gain in speed. Now, as we can understand by the name of it, gain of speed is basically how much speed is gained. So it should be the rotation speed at the driven end to the rotation speed at the driving end, which is true here. So it is NB by NA, and gain of speed and velocity ratio are actually the same parameters. So both of them are rotation speed of driven end or driven gear to rotation speed of driving gear. This can alternatively be written as number of teeth of driving gear to number of teeth of driven gear. Now that we have revisited all the important relations which are used in a gear system, and we have seen a couple of concepts which we missed out in our previous lecture, let us use this knowledge to solve the given numerical. What does it say? It says that the driving gear has a radius 5 cm. So let me write it down. Driving means A. So RA is 5 cm, and the driven gear is 15 cm. So RB is 15 cm. With this information, we are asked to find the gear ratio. Gear ratio. We just saw that gear ratio is NA upon NB. We saw it NA upon NB, that is number of teeth in the driving gear is to the number of teeth in the driven gear. And NA upon NB from our master relation is RA upon RB. Therefore, the gear ratio will turn out to be 5 upon 15, that is 1:3. So we see here, the main idea here is that you might not be directly given the values which you know. We know the relation of gear ratio as NA upon NB, capital NA upon capital NB, but the question may not give you directly those values. The question will need you to see through this equation the given values and replace those accordingly to get the relevant demand of the question. Now the second part says that the driving gear has 15 teeth. So the driving means the A part, and we can write that as NA is equal to 15. We have to find the NB. NB is unknown. Now if we already know RA upon RB, we can use the relation here involving R and capital N to find out NB. What do we know? We know that NB upon NA is RB upon RA. Upon simplifying this, we get NB is equal to capital NA times RB upon RA. That would give us NA is 15, RB is 15 centimeter, and RA is 5, which gives us 45 teeth. So the number of teeth in the driven gear will be 45. Now the last part of the question demands us to find the revolution speed of the driven gear. What is given? The driving gear has 60 revolutions per minute. That is, driving means NA, small NA is equal to 60 REV per minute or 60 RPM. Now again we go back to the master equation. We know NA, we have to find NB, and what else we know both all four of this, so we can use either of them. Let me use these two. So N A upon N B is equal to capital N A upon capital N, rather capital N B upon capital N A. This we will, if since we need to find N small n B, I will cross multiply it here, this will go here, this will come here, and we will get small n A capital N A upon capital N B. Simplify it, capital N A is 60 revolutions per minute. See the unit, it is per minute. Capital N A is 15. Capital N B is, we just found out to be 45. So that turns out to be, this gives 320 RPM, revolutions per minute or rotations per minute. But the important thing to note here is that the question has asked us to find how many revolutions does the driven gear have in 1 hour. So we don't need 1 minute, we need 1 hour. This is number of revolutions in 1 minute. So to find number of revolutions in 1 hour, revolution in 1 hour, we can do it number of rev per minute. And how many minutes are there in an hour? 60. So we multiply it with 60. That would give me 60, 20 times 60 is 1200 rev per hour. This concludes the numerical. I hope you see how the relations are applied here. You might not be given the direct values to put in the equations, but you have to twist and see which equation fits to solve the question. The main idea is to understand the concept. Do I understand that the ratio between the number of teeth and the ratio between the radius is same, and the ratio between number of teeth and the ratio between the rotational speed are inverse? Okay, I suggest you to do a question or two on your own to see if you are getting all the concepts. And I will conclude today's lecture. The next lecture we will be discussing about pulleys and pulley system.